very warm good evening to all present here. I think it's a great privilege of all of us Kanpurites for having such a wonderful conference of this magnitude, international magnitude, being conducted in our very own city. And we have some very enthusiastic organizers like Dr. Praveen Katyar, whom I'd really like to congratulate for it. Professor Neelima Gupta, Dr. A.S. Prasad. So we basically have a lot of efforts behind this conference and some wonderful topics being discussed here. And today's topic, in fact, is a very interesting one for which we have a very learned speaker come all the way to Kanpur to guide us. And we definitely will have a lot of questions here because this is a very interesting topic. So at the start of the session, I would like to invite our first chairperson, Professor Madhu Kumar, who is an emeritus professor, Department of Zoology, University of Rajasthan, Jaipur. You all welcome her with all our hearts. So a loud round of applause for Professor Madhu Kumar. Our next chairperson is Professor D.K. Dumka, Emeritus Professor, Bareilly College. Thank you for being here, sir. A round of applause for sir as well. And finally, we have our speaker, our learned speaker, Mr. Shubhraj Bharadwaj, who is an M.Tech and a young scientist from KGMU Lucknow. He is also the executive secretary of Indian Society for Bone Medicine, and he is also a member of the American Oil Chemist Society. So I think you have deep roots in oil, I would say. Welcome, sir.
Thank you, organizers, and especially one of us for always encouraging me. And I'm started off, actually this is the last time and all are tired right now. So I'm just boosted it. Before starting further, I must request the medical fraternity and our wellness ward, the science fraternity, to encourage and to initiate some engineers and some technologists, our fellow IITians, to come and share their thoughts. As such, they have lots of to sayings, a lot of the, because everything here, what happening now, is directly related to the technology. And when we talk about health and when we talk about something like this, so it directly related to the technology. And when we understand the exact technology, what we are saying and what we are doing, then we can interpret what actually the health causes and why the health causes are occurring. So before starting, I must saying a question for all you, who is the responsible for all the controversies in the world? Anyone from the youngsters, who is the responsible for the other controversies in the world? Is your tongue. So, which is responsible for all the mental problems? And secondly, your taste buds, which are responsible for your all health problems. And this is directly related to all the what you are eating. Just in India right now, it is a country where we sleep for eat, taste, and we wake up for taste, and we work for taste. So what enhancing the taste? Anyone? One common thing is used is our different forms of oil and fats. This is called the taste of India. So we must concentrate and all the medical fraternity must concentrate. What we are eating right now is a daily requirement. It's just like your wheat, it's just like your atta, you are eating daily. In any of the form you are eating your cooking oil. So it is a much of the concentration how the much the quality, quantity and quality of your oil is. So any one of you tell me what did you eat in lunch today? Which oil is used in your lunch today? Anyone? No one knows which oil is you are using in your lunch today. Second question. How many times you ask when you go to the restaurant, you ask the waiter, do you have a Bisleri or distilled water? But you never ask him what the oil is using for your cooking, what you are eating exactly. So never you ask the waiter, कि आपने कौन सा कुकिंग ऑयल यूज किया है. थर्ड, डज एनी डॉक्टर आस्क व्हेन यू गो टू द डॉक्टर एंड देन एनी डॉक्टर आस्क यू व्हाट कुकिंग ऑयल यू आर टेकिंग एंड व्हिच कुकिंग ऑयल यू आर टेकिंग डेली. दिस इज अ मोस्ट फैक्टर क्वेश्चन एज फॉर द एंथ्रोपोमेटिक डाटा इज कंसर्न बिकॉज एवरी वन इज टोल्ड व्हेन यू गो टू द हार्ट डॉक्टर व्हेन यू कार्डियोलॉजिस्ट एनीवन जस्ट लाइक सेज आपको ऑयल बंद करना है, आपको फैट बंद करना है, एनीवन, आपको कोई अगर किसी को मोटापा है आपको भी फैट बंद करना है. एवरीवन इज कंसंट्रेटेड टू और इज रिवॉल्विंग अराउंड द फैट एंड ऑयल्स एंड वेरियस फॉर्म्स ऑफ ऑयल इन इंडिया इज कंसर्न्ड इज मस्टर्ड ऑयल, रिफाइंड ऑयल, कोल्ड प्रेस्ड ऑयल, ऑलिव ऑयल, डालडा, प्योर देसी घी. सो व्हाट वी डिसाइड व्हाट वी कंसंट्रेटिंग इज राइट नाउ इज द our population is much more than our consumption. West India population is 24.6% and consumption is 29.4%. So consumption is increasing threefold from last. This is the data of the this is the previous data, but in last 2019 and 2020 it's become fourfold because of the introductions of the pizzas, because of the introductions of the Burger Kings and several MNCs. So it's converted into to fourfold. If you're seeing, the most consumed oil in the country right now is a palm oil, and then is the soya oil, and this converted a burden of omega 6 to you. And what we are talking, अभी सारी बात कर रहे थे omega 3 की omega 6 की concerns की. So this converted your ratio to the 1:17. Your omega 3 and omega 6 ratio is responsible to you, and the country is what is the eating right now. So key point what we need to discuss right now I am is what the oil and fat actually. You are not knowing what the oil and fat are actually. Why do we need them? Where the things are gone we wrong and the our approach to the problem. What we are doing this and what as a technologist we are doing this for. What is the criteria for choosing healthy oil and what could be the best oil. So these are points that are covered later. So what are oil and fat? A simple definition is as per the books and our triglyceride chain something. And but what I say is that there is a no single name and the no single formula can be written to represent the naturally occurring fats and oil because they are the highly complex mixture of triglycerides in which the many different forms of fatty acids are represented. See this chart. This is the showing the different kinds of fatty acids combinations of the different kinds of vegetable oils. What you are seeing right now, you are saying palm oil ganda hai, palm oil is bad. But the palm oil is contain 41% of oleic acid. What you have in your oleic acid, olive oil. So can you say palm oil is bad? Other thing, olive oil has 14% of palmitic acid. Which is contained in the palm oil. High oleic sunflower has more oleic acid than the olive oil itself. Can you say a sunflower oil is better than a olive oil? And that to the olive oil also contains 64% as compared to the you are comparing the sunflower and olive oil. You are see the right difference, 20% difference you are seeing. So why do we need fat? This is all you are know better than me. Why we are do you need fat? Basically, build cell membrane, make myosin sheath, insulate the body, alternate fuel source. Most importantly, hormone production, estrogen, testosterone, testosterone, progesterone, and active form of vitamin D are the all formed from the cholesterol and are needed to be maintained in pregnancy, development of the sex characteristics, and the regulate the calcium level in our body. According to the AHA, about 25% of the cholesterol in body comes from your diet and 75% from your liver and the cell. But why we are not concentrating on oil and fat which are we are taking? So why we say fat and lipids are bad and where they gone wrong? First thing, refined oil is very bad. You don't need to eat. Everyone and every dietitian in this country is right now saying refined oil is bad and we are not recommend for eating. But the fact is actual is about the fourfold increase in the refined oil consumption. Cold press oil are best. This is also booming from the last 2 years. Cold press bahut hi achhe oil hai, wahi khane chahiye. Palm oil to aap chhod dijiye. Palm oil jaisi naam sunte log kehte what palm oil is so bad. So first we start with the palm oil. Most controversial vegetable oil in this country accordingly. According to the Ramdev Babaji, palm oil is so inexpensive and bad. वो कहते हैं कि सबसे चीप ऑयल है और खाना नहीं चाहिए. अकॉर्डिंग टू द रिसर्चर, ड्यू टू द सैचुरेटेड फैट एंड पाल्मिटिक एसिड, इट कुड हैव बीन अ कार्सिनोजेनिक कार्डियोवास्कुलर इफेक्ट्स. बट अभी मैंने आपसे इससे पहले एक स्लाइड आपको दिखाई कि 40% ऑफ ऑलिक एसिड कंटेन्ड बाय द पाम ऑयल. द पाम ऑयल ट्री कट डाउन प्रीमैच्योरली. द मेन इशू इज द ड्यू टू द हाई डिमांड ऑफ पाम ऑयल, देयर इज अ डिफॉरेस्टेशन एंड लीडिंग टू द क्रूशियल हेल्थ इफेक्ट्स. These are the some good things which are told about the palm oil. All which are agreed to the natural oxidative, natural properties, nutritional properties, and oxidative stability. A recent study has been significantly shown to protect the heart and blood vessels from the plague and ischemic injuries. This is a recent study published in the 2018, the effect of dietary palm oil, a cardiovascular risk factor in healthy adult. This is clearly showing that the intervention time is more important than the quality of oil. How much oil we are taking individually or how much the time we are taking oil from the last 4 years and 2 years and 6 years is should be in the concern rather than the what kind of oil are we are eating. Saturated and unsaturated, what we are dealing with in the great dilemma ki aapko saturated lena hai, unsaturated lena hai, polyunsaturated lena hai. If somebody is asked you right away what you want to eat, what oil you want to eat, you have no options. You just say main to mustard oil khata hu, cold press hota hai, ghar se nikalta hai, wahi khata hu. Somebody says I have sunflower oil, sunflower oil. But all the things which are concerned, whether is bad, good, saturated, polyunsaturated, ghee, butter, sunflower, mustard oil, all you are knowing about dropsy is concerned with the mustard oil and everything, refined versus cold pressed oil, this I want to show you. Seeds such as rapeseed oil, soybean oil, corn, sunflower, safflower, etc. cannot yield oil through natural extraction techniques. To extract oil from these seeds, only chemical refining process can work because it lead to process the lecithin and lignins. अब क्या होता है, जैसे cold pressed oil we are taking, so they contain high amount of lignins, high amount of lecithins, so they will not stored properly from the they can need proper storage, proper concern to be rolled out later for use. Fortification in India right now, everyone saying fortified with A, fortified with B, fortified with C, whatever, ADEK, fat soluble vitamins. But this is a study which showing the lowest stability of vitamin A observed in the liquid oil samples, and saturated fat vitamin A loses 5 to 10% only, but the liquid oil sample, saturated, unsaturated, can leave the observed liquid samples. So when and where we are gone wrong? Clearly, excessive frying, reheating, and not follow the instruction which are written on the your packet. Excessive regarding adulteration is absolutely yes, it is doing right now. But most of the thing is we are not working ethically and we don't know how to use the correct way of oil. हम क्या करते हैं घर में, अगर आपको ऑयल को पकाना है, एक कटोरी में लिया उसको रख दिया, उसके बाद उसको रीहीट किया, दो दिन तक उसको ही यूज कर रहे हैं. इट इज क्लियरली ऑक्सीडाइज, वो उसको हवा में है, ऑक्सीडाइज हो रहा है. दिस इज क्लियरली ऑक्सीडाइज. इट इज नॉट ऑफ द बिजनेस विद द ऑयल इज बैड समथिंग. इट इज जस्ट अबाउट व्हाट वी आर यूजिंग. बाहर आप अगर हम लार्जेस्ट प्रोस्पेक्टिव्स की बात करें तो बाहर जो स्टॉल्स लगे हैं, सब चीज लगे हैं, दे आर रीहीटिंग, रेगुलरली रीहीटिंग. ट्रांसफॉर्म इज फॉर्मिंग. What I जब स्टार्ट किया तब बोला मैंने कि आपने कौन से लंच में ऑयल खाया. यू डोंट नो हाउ दे आर कुकिंग. दिस इज अ सीरियस कंसर्न एंड वी शुड मॉनिटर व्हाट वी आर हैपनिंग राइट नाउ. सो ये फॉल्ट ऑयल की तो नहीं है. फर्स्ट, ऑल थिंग्स इन दिस वर्ल्ड इज टॉक्सिक. द राइस ग्रोज इन द राइट एंड बैड वे डिसाइड इज इट पॉइजन और इट इज अ रेमेडी. सेकेंड, we have exploited the nature's gift. Why can't we use things in nature in own way? Third, science and technology is a good servant but a mad master. We all know that. According to the WHO, introduced three important factors for the nutritional evolutions of oil. First, presence of antioxidants. Second, ratio of saturated, monounsaturated and polyunsaturated fatty acids. Third, essential fatty acid ratio. None of the oil in this country is having such kind of profiling. Some having different kinds of fatty acids, some having different kinds of saturated, monounsaturated concerns. So what we have, we like to eat. So this is a criteria we have maintained: good frying stability, good shelf life, contain proper amount of omegas, made good quantity of raw material, raw storage, omega 3 and omega 6 ratio. This is a major controversy for the doctors and for the engineers and for the scientists also, how to correct the omega 3 and omega 6 ratio in our body. Majority of people in this country are literally unaware about what is the significance of omega 3 and omega 3 consumption, 3 and omega 6 ratio. And this 40% of the Indian population is a vegetarian. They don't eat fish, so they, even the Solomon fish. And they do not take omega 3 and any kind of supplement. Flaxseed oil is only the available source which is available in the market, which provide you sufficient quantity, but the limitations which will I coming through. So our approach to this controversy, our approach, what we are doing as a technologist, and what is needed right now, as the sir is saying, food is deteriorating, food quality is deteriorating. We should focus on the farmers, what they are doing. This is we are doing from the last 2 years. This is an ethical food supply system. Ethical farming is somewhat needed. It is ethical farming of medical importance crop, followed by the soil testing, seed quality and testing. Second, efficient storage and collection of raw material. Third is the ethical processing and quality assessment. Third is a high-end packing and quality check. Efficient ready pack quality check. And then ethically distributed and marketing. Why we are using ethical words so much? Because none of thing and none of concept of wellness is possible until we have followed the ethics. Ethics in the production industry, ethics in the farmer industry, ethics in the marketing industry. So what we are eating, the consumer is eating, is a product not ethically processed. So this concern lead to the diseases and some other concerns. And this is a serious issue, I must say. The audience is low, but this should be here by the 20 to 20,000 people right now here. What is happening right now to us is just a farmer. मैं गया था फार्मर से मिला हूँ. वी आर होल्डिंग अ कंपनी एंड वी आर डूइंग दिस फ्रॉम द लास्ट टू ईयर्स. दे सेड कि हम ये चीज़ उगाते हैं मगर 40% हमको उसको देना अच्छा लगता है जो हमको अच्छे पैसे देता है, और 40% हम 50% अगर हमारे टमाटर खराब है, गंदे हैं, तो वो सॉस बन गई. एंड दिस इज अ फैक्ट. फिर उसमें मेडिकल साइंसेज भी कुछ नहीं कर सकती जब तक हम, क्योंकि दीज टू थिंग्स, वॉट द फूड इज, वॉट द ऑयल इज, वॉट वी आर ईटिंग is important, and we are not concentrating on this on the high end level. This is a simple approach what we are doing in the lab. From the last 4 years, we have just made an oil with the help of HBTI Kanpur. This is the oil technologies excellence for the India and world. With the help of KGMU and sir, we have developed a platform and developed the oil that have all the properties omega-3, omega-6, omega-9 in a single oil content. It also have the polyunsaturated, saturated and all the types of fatty acid in a single oil. Imagine what we are using to make this oil. We are using palm. And we are using flaxseed oil. Both the oil has very much of limitations, and we combining these two forms of very effectively, just to following by following the ethical food supply management system. And this oil have the smoke. Previously the smoke point of flaxseed oil is 57.2, and the melting point is minus 14 degrees centigrade. It is highly unsaturated and used in the paint industry. Palm oil have the high smoke point of 160 and melting point of 34 degrees centigrade. It is a highly unstable point with no trans fats and nothing. We blend this oil. We also have a patent on this. And this is published in the book of Elsevier right later. In the global, we'll show you later in the later slides. And this gives you a proper balanced form of omega-3, omega-6 and omega-9. With the regular percentage of 29, 25 and 39%. And we also make a clinical trial here in KGMC. Why we are, I am in KGMC? That is, we have done the clinical trials. There are 4 clinical trials right now running on the KGMC on this oil only in the different kinds of fats. We have also concerning omega-3 and omega-6 ratio in the plasma. And we have also major cohort studies going on the omega live study, which is called the which is also going on. This is a methodology we have used. We have taken the subjects from the cardiology. Dr. V.S. Narayan mentored that time. And this study is conducted. And this is significantly decreases your LDL and triglycerides level. This is what I want to show. The smoke point is the more than the olive oil and canola oil, right? This is a technological revolution in the industry right now. It is the most balanced oil in the country, a moderate omega-3 and also have the lignans. This is published in the chapter also right now in the role of functional food security with the help of Ronald Watson and Ram Singh. What we have done in the clinical impact of the research? The research should be done for the clinical impact and social impact. Clinical impact is the how much palm oil you're using right now in this country. I said previously, 40% of the oil is consumption is here. So why, and the consumption and the production of flaxseed oil is only 4.5%, which our research and we are boosted is to the 2% rise in the flaxseed production. And 21 farmers, this is the old data, 41 farmers are right now till not directly benefit by the research and awareness of omega-3 increase within the society. This is the study we are talking about. International Society for Medical Food and Nutrition now taken in this. And the Omega Eli study is now globally running out, in which we are taking the awareness about the omega-3s and omega-6 concerns, and we are focusing about. So what can be done in the reality? We are not talking about the things which are the substationary or cannot be possible. What we can do is consume the variety of fatty acid at a time. Change your chronobiology. No one can, without changing your chronobiology, can treat you. Eat at proper time, eat, sleep at proper time, enjoy eating, but in the right time and right quality, quantity, and eat according to your habitat. What we are saying, eat according to the habitat is, somebody is saying ki hum fish oil kha rahe hain, USA ka hai, bahut achha. Somebody is saying hum protein kha rahe hain, wo California bana hai, bahut achha. But what the body is recognizing is our habitat. Our environment is different, their environment is different. Our body is different, our whole habitat, our whole physiology is different as per the environment is concerned. So what we eat according to your habit. And this is last, I will show you. First, we are starting respecting our country. Second, work ethically and do something which is ethical. Then only there the wellness, concept of wellness is possible. Let your food be your medicine. Focus more about food quality, food concerns, and food beliefs. Focus on farmers first, then focus on doctors later on. So what we are requiring right now is a chain of food supply management system, which is supported by the doctors, so that we can do something which is productive, I must say. So nature is so smart, we don't need to convert it or some process out. We just eat what we have, but in a pure form. That's it, and that's I want to say. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat. Yeah, any questions or further you will ask in the.
Lecture. As you have shown a long list of the edible oils, and these days it has been said that you don't take a single type of oil, change the different types of oils. So are they good?
Changing oils in different forms, as I say, we have received the different fatty acid at a different time. What we are saying, so what we need omega 3, omega 6 and omega 9 balance. We also need a saturated fat, and we also need a unsaturated and polyunsaturated fat. So what the concept is out is, if we taking the varieties of oil at a time, or we are converting and we are changing the oil's habits, so we can consume these fatty acids at the different times. But what we are focusing on right now in the research, the blend can be done, and blend can do the things, and we can focus on, if you say the coconut oil, if you blend this coconut oil with the some productive oil which has the high omega 3, omega 6 content, so it can be done. So what we are focusing right now, but what the end thing is coming up is, ma'am, what I'm saying this is ethical farming. Hamara jo storage hai, what we have done, jab farmer usko storage karta hai, तो सीड मॉइस्चर खा जाते हैं और डिट्रोइट हो जाता है. सो सीड की क्वालिटी पहले से ही खराब हो गई है. सेकंड थर्ड फेज में जब वो स्टोरेज हो रहा है हमारी कंट्री में, सो दे आर कंसर्न इन द स्टोर्स एंड वेरियस फॉर्म्स. वो पहले कंटेनर्स में जाता है, फिर हमारे पैकेट्स में जाता है, फिर वहां पर रखकर के हमारे पास पहुंचता है. देयर इज सो मच ऑफ टाइम, सो इट डिट्रोइटेड आवर मैटर. सो व्हाट इज द कंसर्न राइट नाउ, इफ वी टेक इन अ कोल्ड प्रेस ऑयल एंड यूज विद इन वन मंथ and 15 days and blend it with some good oil which having the both the saturated and unsaturated can do the things better.
And you have said also that heating and reheating, that is very risky for developing the cancer. Do you think that there should be some awareness program regarding the person who are selling the samosas and kachoris, because nobody is going to throw so much oil?
Actually, this is the topic of concern, very much topic of concern. What is the frying techniques? This is the frying technique. Can I show you a frying technique? Frying technique, you have put in the kadhai, so you will hear a chachar chachar. Jab bhi aap koi aap karte hain koi bhi cheez, so there is a moisture is coming out and dealing with the oil. So there is a time when the moisture is stop coming out and it is going down the brown hona shuru ho jata. So humko kya karna hai, jaise hi wo moisture content khatam ho usse pehle humko usko nikal lena. So this is the quality check ki oil jo hai penetrate nahi hua hai itna food mein, and it cannot, it usne uski quality ko deteriorate nahi kiya. But again ma'am, this is the problem for us because we live for taste. And अगर इंडिया इज अ टेस्ट कंट्री, अगर हमारे पास इतने सारे टेस्ट हैं, अगर वो टेस्ट नहीं आएगा तो वी कैन नॉट डू थिंग्स. सो विदाउट ब्लेमिंग एनी अदर फॉर अदर थिंग्स, वी शुड change our habits, our cooking habits, and there should be, yes, there should be a cooking workshop, proper cooking workshop should be done for good health, I say wellness concept.
Think the composition of the omega 3, 6 and 9 ratio in a normal mustard oil, which the people are using mostly, you have not shown that now. How much they contain? Content of omega 3, omega 6 and omega 9?
Omega 3, 9 and 6 in mustard oil.
But shown it in your slide. You have shown the different formula oils and other things.
So mustard oil basically the most omega 3 and omega 6 ratio jiske andar sabse set hai ya fir jisko kehte hain omega 3 omega 6 ratio is defined is a different kind of thing. Omega 3 and omega 6 and omega 9 teeno cheeze mustard oil mein content uric acid jo hota hai 40% hota hai, that decreases the things which going down. अगर हम मस्टर्ड ऑयल की बात कर रहे हैं यहाँ पे, सो मस्टर्ड ऑयल में उतना परसेंटेज ऑफ जो रिकमेंडेड ओमेगा 3 है वो नहीं है. वी सेड कि मस्टर्ड ऑयल इज गुड एंड वी आर टेकिंग अ ओमेगा 3 फ्रॉम दिस. दिस इज नॉट अ फैक्ट एंड दिस इज मिथ बिकॉज वी यूजिंग एवरीथिंग फ्रॉम द फ्राइंग एंड दिस इज नॉट पॉसिबल टू गेट अ ओमेगा 3 फ्रॉम द कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ ओमेगा 3 इन मस्टर्ड ऑयल इज लो. रादर देन आई नॉट हैव डाटा दैट टाइम बट विल शो लेटर व्हाट इज इट.
Excessive consumption of the omega 6 and omega 9 may lead to the cancer.
So proper balanced form of
so the ratio should be maintained, otherwise the patient will suffer from the cancer.
What I am saying this only.
Omega 3 is good for you as a work as a protective thing.
Yeah, yeah.
You see, you take the omega 3 and omega 6 and omega 9, then it's a carcinogenic.
No, sir. Basically, what we are dealing with is we are correcting our ratio.
20 years in Kanpur, and in this long journey, almost homemakers, especially mothers, who are very confused about the kind of oil they should use, and especially Indian cooking is very different from other country cooking because of the kind of chaukas and tadkas that we use in our daily cooking to make it more tasty. And Indian mothers have this wonderful knack of preparing different varieties for their children. So every day the children, whether they require it or not, but mothers always have this at the back of their mind. And let me just share a small incident with you, that today mere ghar mein main instruction deke aayi hu maid ko ki samosa banne hain, but wo ghar mein ban rahe hain. And the amount of oil, the kind of oil, that has all been instructed to her. So as sir said, agar hum log ghar ka khana khayein, to shayad problems kam ho. And there is one major problem with the Indians, which is with their arteries.
Are we invited for samosa?
Absolutely, sir. Absolutely. Most welcome. I hope they don't finish off by the time we reach home. So, what I mean to say is that we Indians, just like hamari sadke India mein narrow hoti hain, waise hi arteries are also equally narrow. So, we are also definitely at a higher cardiovascular risk. एंड जिस तरह की हम लोग कुकिंग घरों में करते हैं, तो सबसे पहला मेरा सवाल आपसे यही रहेगा कि इंडियन कुकिंग के लिए सबसे बढ़िया ऑयल, सिंगल ऑयल और ब्लेंड ऑफ ऑयल क्या रहेगा? एंड दैट टू इज लाइक वेरी हाई टेम्परेचर कुकिंग.
यहाँ पे एक्चुअली मैं ये चीज बताना चाह रहा था आपको कि अब मैं वो कहूँगा कि लगेगा मार्केटिंग कर रहा है, बट दिस इज से आर ओमेगा लाइक बिकॉज वी हैव कॉम्बिनेशंस ऑफ ऑयल्स, वी यूज द कॉम्बिनेशंस ऑफ ऑयल. और अगर हमको एक प्रॉपर सैचुरेटेड फैट चाहिए, स्मोक पॉइंट हाई चाहिए,
डेफिनेटली.
और उसके और अगर हम बात करें ओलिव ऑयल की, स्मोक पॉइंट इज नॉट वर्दी,
नॉट लो, आई मीन नॉट हाई,
नॉट हाई. सो इट इज नॉट रिकमेंडेड फॉर कुकिंग एंड इट इज आल्सो नॉट प्रोवाइडिंग योर द प्रॉपर ओमेगा 3 ओमेगा 6 एंड ओमेगा 9 रेशियो व्हाट वी नीड. इट इज एसेंशियल फैटी एसिड एंड वाजर वी नीड टू टर्शियरी व्हाट आई सेड कि प्रॉपर स्टोरेज ऑफ सीड्स होना चाहिए. फार्मर्स जो डिफाइन होने चाहिए कि उनको कहाँ से सीड रखना है, दिस शुड बी डन ऑन द फार्मर लेवल्स, क्योंकि हमारी जो फूड होता है वो डिट्रोइट होना शुरू हो जाता है जहाँ से फार्मर्स ने उसको लिया है. एंड दिस इज द मेजर ऑफ कंसर्न कि हमारा स्टोरेज कंडीशंस या हमारी जो फार्मर्स हैं वो इतने ज़्यादा बैकवर्ड्स में जी रहे हैं इस टाइम. मतलब कि आई एम कहना पड़ रहा है मुझे, बट मैं वर्क कर रहा हूँ, मैं गया हूँ किसानों के साथ वर्क कर रहा हूँ, मुझे डेवलप करने में बहुत दिक्कत हुई कि वहां पे मैं -14 में फ्लैक्स सीड्स को रख रहा हूँ सीड्स को, उसके बाद वो बन रही है मार्केट में. जितनी फ्लैक्स सीड है सब लिनसीड है, जितना ऑयल है सब लिनसीड ऑयल है. दिस इज नॉट अ फ्लैक्स सीड ऑयल. देयर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन अ फ्लैक्स सीड एंड लिनसीड ऑयल. देयर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन द अलसी जो मार्केट में मिल रही है जो हमारे पास है. सो वो हमको रखनी पड़ती है कि वी नीड टू टैकल दिस, कि हमको फूड क्वालिटी मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम चाहिए अगर हमको कोई चीज अच्छी बनानी है. और इंडियन मदर्स को मैं कहूँगा अगर उनको फ्राइंग करनी है तो वो देसी घी में कर सकते हैं, डाल्टा में कर सकते हैं जैसे वो पहले करते थे. उसका रीजन है कि वो सैचुरेटेड पॉइंट में हाई है, वो स्मोक करता है. तो मगर अगर उनको ये कुकिंग की टेक्निक मालूम है कि हमको जब वो तड़का लगा रहे हैं कितने स्टैंडर्ड पे लगाना है और कब निकाल लेना है, कि सबसे बड़ी चीज है. तो सर ने जैसे नाम ने कहा कुकिंग वर्कशॉप होनी बहुत जरूरी है, एक कुकिंग गाइडेंस बहुत होनी जरूरी है. जैसे कुकरी वर्कशॉप पहले मेरी मदर ने होम साइंस किया था. सो होम साइंस में मुझे नहीं पता था इतना कि इतना सब कुछ भी होता है. सो पहले लोग कंसंट्रेटेड होते थे, स्टडीज को बहुत सीरियसली लेते थे. आर वी आर वर्किंग ऑन द डिग्रीज ओनली. सो अगर वो चीज अगर वो पढ़ाई जा रही है बट दिस इज नॉट कन्वर्टिंग इनटू द प्रैक्टिकल नॉलेज.
And so, what do you have to say about a blend of rice bran and safflower, because they have a pretty high smoking point?
They are good, but again, safflower, sunflower, it is how they are extracting. They are extracting by the refined something solvent extraction process. So it may also trigger.
But all these things are not mentioned on the labels as such.
What we can use easily is a mustard oil, which is available in country, and blend it with the dalda.
Okay, but for deep frying.
I'm saying deep frying for the dalda.
Okay. And how should we refresh our oils? Like oil एक बार use हो गया, उसके बाद जब second time use आता है.
Destroy it and use in biodiesel.
Okay. So you according to you we should Sir, not reuse what,
exactly,
the
exactly destroy it and use in biodiesel. और आपको खुले में नहीं छोड़ना है. They are.
It has to be covered.
3 days आपको रख के आप उसको लगा रहे हो उसी पे फिर आप कर रहे हो. This is not a thing. एक दो बार हो जाता है मगर ये कि वो हमारी आदत में आ गया. वी हैव इनटू द आवर हैबिट्स ओनली. सो इट इज अ मोस्ट कंसर्न एरिया. हमको इस पे बहुत वर्क करना पड़ेगा क्योंकि हमारे पास इतने मार्केट में स्टॉल्स हैं जो लगे हुए हैं पूरे, उसमें आपको उतने हटाने में बहुत टाइम लग जाएगा. सो वी नीड अ पॉलिसी फॉर दिस एंड वी आर वर्किंग ऑन दिस एट द इंडियन सोसाइटी ऑफ क्रोनो मेडिसिन एंड इंटरनेशनल सोसाइटी ऑफ मेडिकल फूड एंड न्यूट्रिशन विद द हेल्प ऑफ डॉक्टर बंसी साबू सर, डॉक्टर नरसिंह वर्मा एंड द टू एक्सपर्ट्स फ्रॉम द एचबीटीआई कानपुर, आर गाइड डॉक्टर राकेश त्रिवेदी, इज द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ वर्ल्ड टेक्नोलॉजीज ऑफ इंडिया. वी आर मेकिंग एन गाइडलाइंस ऑन दिस एंड वी आर श्योरली सूनली पब्लिश अ बुक ऑन दिस रिगार्डिंग वॉट कैन बी द इंडियन गाइडलाइंस फॉर द एडिबल ऑयल इंडस्ट्री इज यूजिंग. सो वी आर वर्किंग ऑन दिस इन वेरी हार्डली. And surely we will get you in the 1 or 2 years. You will get.
Okay. So I believe हमारे देश में बहुत जो पुरानी पद्धतियाँ थी जिसमें हम लोग अलसी काफी यूज करते थे और अब अलसी को एज अ सुपर फूड प्रमोट किया जाता है. सो आई थिंक अलसी को हम लोग जैसे फ्लैक्सीड ऑयल डायरेक्टली हम लोग जो है नहीं उसका लेते हैं, वी मेक लड्डूज आउट ऑफ इट. इससे हम पाउडर बना रहे हैं एंड उसको कंज्यूम करना ज्यादा सेफ है rather than the
powder में मैम फिर से हमने उसको हीट कर लिया है क्योंकि हमने उसको ग्राइंड किया गया है. वी नीड टू पल्वराइज इट एंड देन वी शुड गेट. और उसमें भी कंसर्न है कि आपका कहां से आ रहा है, कितनी स्टोरेज थी, क्या कैपेसिटी थी, कितने स्टोरेज.
एंड वी आल्सो हैव अलसी कैप्सूल्स अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट. हाउ सेफ.
वो रिकमेंडेशन नहीं रखते हैं. ओनली 1 mg दे गए 1 mg एंड यू नीड अराउंड 5 to 6 ml पर डे. सो फ्लैक्सीड ऑयल जो है कैप्सूल्स जो है वो मिलते हैं मार्केट में. दे आर प्रॉपरली मार्केटिंग प्रोपेगेंडा. 1 mg में आपको कितना ओमेगा 3 मिल जाएगा. नॉट
ओके दैट कैन नॉट बी टेकन सेवरल टाइम्स अ डे और दैट कैन नॉट बी एडेड टू फूड बेसिकली.
नो.
एंड व्हाट अबाउट द साल्मन ओमेगा 3 सप्लीमेंट्स दैट वी आर गेटिंग इन द मार्केट.
देयर इज आल्सो अ ट्रायल जस्ट कमिंग आउट इन द 2019 की जो हमारी फिशेस थी, जो हम सोलोमन फिश थी, उनको हमने बहुत सारा ओमेगा 6 खिलाया है. वो फिश है, उनकी मॉर्फोलॉजी फिजियोलॉजी डिफरेंट नहीं थी हमसे, ऐसा कुछ नहीं था. मतलब उनकी फिजियोलॉजी भी अल्टर हो चुकी है आल्सो. सो उनका भी ओमेगा 3 ओमेगा 6 लेवल बिगड़ गया है. व्हाट दे आर एक्सपेक्टिंग आई डोंट नो. सो एक्चुअली व्हाट वी आर डूइंग राइट नाउ इज व्हाट कैन बी हैपन इन आवर कंट्री So, and what can be the our recommendation for this? So, flaxseed fish oil, I think, can we do if processed? And I don't know the source of fish, basically. And gelatin is also a concern of, or kuch vegans nahi lete vegetarian country, 40% hamari. So, we are working on the larger perspective as such as for the public. And we need to do something for the public, not from the allied customers only. So we are also working on the for the whole community and India is concerned.
Thank you so much for your proficient delivery and such an extensive and comprehensive discussion about the most, I would say, awaited topic of the day. Thank you so much.
Presentation. Thank you.